N.Gokulakrishnan.
Badiya, sir.
Thank you, sir. First of all, I want to convey my heartiest New Year wishes to the Honorable Vice Chairman and to my all colleagues present in this August House. The National Bank for Agricultural and Rural Development Amendment Bill 2017 is a landmark step on two counts. Number one, the bill increases the authorized capital of apex body of agriculture and rural development by six folds from the existing rupees 5,000 crore to 30,000 crores. Number two, the bill also seeks to amend certain classes in the light of reference to MSME Development Act 2006 and the Companies Act 2013 in the proposed legislation. Some political analysts say that had the NDA government been more sensitive to the farmers' demands, it would have performed better in the recently concluded Gujarat Assembly election. Okay, past is past. Now I appreciate that by this step, the focus of the government is shifted towards empowering the farmers rather than resorting to populist measures. Sir, as far as the promotion of agriculture is concerned, NABARD and SEBI should come forward to work together to improve farmers' participation by encouraging farmers' producers' organization in commodity exchanges and futures trading. This will enable the farmers to get better prices for their produce. The government had already declared to double the agriculture income by the year 2022, which makes the role of NABARD more critical in achieving the goal. The proposed increase in authorized capital would enable NABARD to respond to the commitments it has undertaken, particularly in respect of the long-term irrigation fund and the recent cabinet decision regarding lending finance to cooperative banks. Sir, the basic objectives of NABARD is to create rural development program for alleviation of poverty and unemployment through creation of basic social and economic infrastructure, provision of training to rural unemployed youth, and providing employment to marginal farmers and laborers to discourage seasonal and permanent migration to urban areas. But actually speaking, youth are really migrating to urban areas and the aged remain in rural areas, rural India, struggling for day-to-day livelihood. With regard to poverty, I would like to mention here that the rural development report, which is also endorsed by the government, says 7% of rural population is very poor and villages in eastern India are worst affected. It is to be noted that there are so many issues to be taken care by the government through NABARD with regard to rural development. Though the government is spending a lot, there is a lot to achieve for rural development. For example, good road for transportation, uninterrupted power supply, quality drinking water, better sanitary and health, good education, particularly literacy for women, are some of the important issues to be taken care of by NABARD through liberal financing. The low female literacy rate has had a dramatically negative impact on family planning, and by promoting female literacy rate, we can definitely reduce the population growth. Please note down, sir, this is very, very important. Why I mentioned this is that on one hand, the extent of agricultural land is shrinking day by day for many reasons, while on the other hand, there is no proper control on rapid population growth. So, sir, the next point is that under the 1981 Act, the upper lending limit of NABARD was only rupees 20 lakhs for plant and machinery. Now, the bill raises the limit of medium enterprises up to rupees 10 crore in the manufacturing sector and rupees 5 crore in the service sector. Sir, in this regard, I would like to suggest one important thing, that the government may exclude the medium enterprises from the scope of finance through NABARD by retaining only micro and small enterprises, which will be helpful to create more employment opportunities to rural youth. Even if the government is pumping more capital, it would be difficult to maintain the capital if it starts lending finance to the medium enterprises, and I am really afraid that the capital will be drained very fast. Sir, for me, sir, 1 minute. Sir.
Yeah, 1 minute.
Sir, I have got 7 minutes. Sir, for medium enterprises, there are so many banks are available. For example, IDBAs are there, all other commercial banks are there. So coming to the last point, there is a mixed response with regard to 100% equity of central government by totally delinking RBI, which had a token share of 0.4%. Now it is really a moot question how effectively RBI is going to function as a regulator in this changed scenario. So with that, I conclude and I welcome the bill. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next speaker is...